when I was a kid, my skincare routine was just washing my face with soap at night.
Wait, you used soap? I don't think my routine was even that complicated. But seriously, today's kids are inundated with advertising and social media about how to manage their skin.
There seems to be a skincare craze online, and here to talk about it is Dr. Ingrid Polkari.
Dr. Polkari is a pediatric dermatologist at the University of Minnesota, and she just finished giving a talk on the skincare craze. Dr. Polkari, welcome.
Thank you. So how is it that social media is affecting how young people are doing their skincare routines now?
There's a lot of trends just circulating out there. Kids are watching a lot of social media. They're doing what other kids are doing. And they're starting to do routines that are very complex, involving many, many products.
So when you were talking about some of these trends, you introduced some terms and concepts that I found, frankly, alarming. Can you start by explaining what we mean by purging?
Of course. So purging is a term that teens use to discuss what happens after you start a topical retinoid, usually for your acne treatment. And what happens is there's increased skin cell turnover, which means that acne pimples are going to push to the surface of the skin, and you might have an increased number of pimples for the first 2 weeks or so after starting the medication.
So what about homemade moisturizers or sunscreens that people make?
So I do have some concerns about this because sometimes the ingredients that are being mixed together may not be the best for sensitive skin. A lot of recipes include things like essential oils, and essential oils are not really meant to be applied directly to the skin. The sunscreen piece is a little bit concerning as well because I don't think we have any way to test the SPF of these products.
So you also mentioned beef tallow, but not in the context of French fries.
Correct. So this is another trend that's circulating. I think this is circulating more among parents than it is among kids, though. Parents are liking to moisturize their kids with beef tallow, which is essentially the fat byproducts of cows.
And then lastly, slugging. What is that?
So slugging, I'm not sure where the term comes from, simply refers to occluding your skin with something really thick and greasy like petroleum jelly. And the idea is to lock in the moisture and prevent escape of transpirable water, which will hydrate your skin.
And you also mentioned some social media trends having to do with ultraviolet light exposure. And those, I'm sure as a dermatologist, were pretty concerning. Do you mind reviewing those?
Yeah, there are some concerning trends that are surfacing, and these are relatively new. So the first is something called UV contouring, which means you're applying sunscreen only to specific areas of your face or body in order to tan the other areas and maybe have your muscles look more sculpted or your cheekbones highlighted, for example. There are also trends out there called the sunburn challenge, where kids are intentionally getting sunburned and then sharing that on social media so they can get reactions. And then finally, there's this risky trend where kids are using the UV index to chase the sun's rays. So instead of using it to protect themselves and decide when they should protect their skin from the sun, they're using it to decide when they should go out and get a suntan.
Oh, what could possibly go wrong?
So what are age-appropriate things pre-pubertal, pubertal, and adult skin can tolerate and that you would recommend?
So the skincare routine for a pre-pubertal child is actually really simple. Just a gentle cleanser and a moisturizer is all you need. Once the skin starts producing oil around the time of puberty, you may want to use an acne cleanser or something like that in place of a gentle cleanser, but of course that moisturizer with SPF is still recommended. And then finally, once you reach adult age, it might be appropriate to pursue some of the more cosmeceutical type products, things like dark spot correctors, wrinkle creams, things like that. But none of those were actually created for young kids.
Dr. Ingrid Polkari, thank you so much for talking with us and for justifying my whole skincare routine as a child.
It was my pleasure. Thanks for having me.